We seem to always have a very, very large fan base here in the Düsseldorf region. But, you know, other than the krautrock influence, it's not really that much of a big connection, apart from the fact I think it was the first place we came to in Germany in early 1982 to do a TV show, oddly enough. We are really spoilt when it comes to our audiences, and we've had so many shows on this tour that have just stood out, and it's like so difficult to pick, you know. Sometimes I think it's really down to your mental state, whether you enjoy a show or not, because the audiences have pretty much all been fantastic. I think that the visuals for the live shows have changed quite dramatically, and they seem to change quite a lot with each tour that we go out on. You know, because we only tour every 3 or 4 years, so there seems to be quite a big jump in what's available. When we first turned up, for instance, at the production rehearsals for this tour, we were actually blown away by the clarity of the screens, just how high definition they were. And I would like to think that we are a good hybrid between rock music and electronic music, and, you know, we were obviously influenced by Kraftwerk. You know, they were the main group that existed that was so influential when we were young teenagers. I used to live in Berlin. I lived there for 2 years before the wall came down, and, you know, I wasn't allowed into East Germany for some reason. They wouldn't tell me why. I tried to, you know, cross over. I went under the on the U-Bahn, not the underground, and when I got to the front of the queue, a guard came over and asked for my passport and said, told me to wait, and he just came back after about 10 minutes and gave me my passport back and said, zurück nach West-Berlin. And I said, warum? And he went, zurück nach West-Berlin. And at that point, I just left. And I had a girlfriend at the time who'd already gone through, and, you know, I didn't find her for like another half an hour. But yeah, they were weird times. If you look at the number of songs that Dave wrote on Delta Machine and the extended edition, I think it's more like 5.5, I think. And when he first started writing songs back on Playing the Angel, it was just like 3 tracks. And I think, I mean, he is working with different people, so I think that the end result is different, but I think he is improving all the time, and I think he tends to edit himself more these days, which I think is very important for a songwriter to do. And, you know, and I think that the progress is very evident to me, you know, and I think it is to the fans as well, that the song quality is better. I mean, there are some that I use in general. Like, there are some apps that I use in general, like Words with Friends, and you know, on travel days, I play Scrabble all the time, usually with Peter or anyone else who will play with me. Peter, the keyboard player in the band, and I mean, I have lots of music apps that I've downloaded, but I have all these great intentions of using them while I'm on tour, but I just never get around to actually get, you know, trying them. I think that we've changed quite a lot and learnt quite a lot on this tour, and, you know, teaming up with Telekom has meant that we've done things that we wouldn't normally do that we haven't normally done in the past. Things like the live streamings and the live interviews, you know, on air. Yeah, they're just things that we just haven't even thought about in the past. And, you know, I think it is just such a great way to reach a huge audience. And we're also very careful with who we partner with. And I think because they are so technology-based, I think it is a very good mixture.